A high entropy value is interpreted as a low predictability variable. The autocorrelation function is shown in 9. The proposed measure represents a confidence bound of the number of regressors with a linear dependence on the signal. It establishes the grade of possible foreseeability in the basis of its periodical behavior as long as forecasting crime is given in terms of stochastic processes. S macron the average of the signal. The number of lags LG is obtained when CH drops below 0.2C0 for H greater than 0. The chosen statistics are applied over time series whereby a four-dimensional vector, 10, is obtained per signal. Where S is the class identification of the corresponding series, X displacement of the cluster in dimension X, Y displacement of the cluster in dimension Y, and R radius of the cluster. These vectors are arranged in matrices as N, 11. In this way, the analysis is done for each matrix separately. Where C represents the number of clusters. Normalization, the aim is to find the most representative signals, i.e., X, Y, R. The statistics are considered as a way to describe each series, but most of them have a dependence of the scale avoiding a comparison in value. Consequently, a difference of one order of magnitude could be significant in the lags of autocorrelation, but insignificant in the mean. Therefore, normalization is a way to establish a common reference. In this case, the normalization interval is O1 avoiding the value 0. Each MS matrix is independently normalized. Finding the average vectors, an average vector is built from the normalized matrices. As per the last step, this process is independently applied. It is important to emphasize that in a determined clustering, there is an average vector V macron S for each MS. Normalization, the aim is to find the most representative signals, i.e., X, Y, R. The statistics are considered as a way to describe each series, but most of them have a dependence of the scale avoiding a comparison in value. Consequently, a difference of one order of magnitude could be significant in the lags of autocorrelation, but insignificant in the mean. Therefore, normalization is a way to establish a common reference. In this case, the normalization interval is O1 avoiding the value 0. Each MS matrix is independently normalized. Finding the average vectors, an average vector is built from the normalized matrices. As per the last step, this process is independently applied. It is important to emphasize that in a determined clustering, there is an average vector V macron S for each MS. Determining distances, the distance between each row of the matrices MS and the corresponding average vector is computed. Thereby, the Euclidean distance is calculated for all vectors VC as follows. Determining distances, the distance between each row of the matrices MS and the corresponding average vector is computed. Thereby, the Euclidean distance is calculated for all vectors VC as follows. The matrices DS are organized by collecting the distances calculated from the matrices MS. The fittest vectors, finally, the series corresponding to the position of the minimum value in each matrix DS is chosen as the most representative signal. Thus, there are three representative signals obtained from DX, DI, and DR which are referenced as XFT, IFT, and RFT, respectively. These three signals are taken in the forecasting stage as representation of the clustering dynamics for a given number of clusters. Particularly, the representative signals for the best and worst conditions of the MIG index are considered in this work. The fittest vectors, finally, the series corresponding to the position of the minimum value in each matrix DS is chosen as the most representative signal. Thus, there are three representative signals obtained from DX, DI, and DR which are referenced as XFT, IFT, and RFT, respectively. These three signals are taken in the forecasting stage as representation of the clustering dynamics for a given number of clusters. Particularly, the representative signals for the best and worst conditions of the MIG index are considered in this work. Forecasting of representative time series is carried out by means of a custom mimetic algorithm. The heuristic was proposed in as the combination of the differential evolution algorithm and the adaptive neurofuzzy inference system, ANFIS. The general flow graph of the algorithm is shown in the evolutionary algorithm used to tune fuzzy forecasters. This algorithm uses the script of the differential evolution algorithm with a step of local search provided by an adaptive neural fuzzy inference system. A mimetic algorithm allows to take advantage of both global and local search. In this manner, the optimization space can be explored widely and deeply. The differential evolution algorithm, highlighted in orange, is chosen as the global optimizer, on account of its use for optimizing multidimensional real-valued functions. In addition, it has been successfully applied for model optimization of complex systems. Several variants of this algorithm have been proposed in literature, taking into account the multiplicity of elitism strategies, chromosome representations, and mutation operators. ANFIS, highlighted in pink, is implemented as the supervised learning strategy of the mimetic algorithm. It uses the gradient of the objective function on the basis of its differentiability to search for solutions around a locality of the optimization landscape. ANFIS is supported on pseudogenotype fuzzy systems with Gaussian membership functions in the inputs. In addition, the proposed fuzzy system has M rules, which also corresponds to the number of membership functions in each input and the amount of singleton fuzzy sets in the output. Each rule relates the R-th group of membership functions in the inputs with the i-th singleton value in the output. As shown in the flow graph N, when the population is adapted by ANFIS, it is necessary to reevaluate the solutions and later, according to the fitness function, select them. This reevaluation must be carried out since ANFIS relies on the RMSE to evaluate the solutions, but the mimetic algorithm relies on the fitness function. Thus, an interesting individual for ANFIS may not necessarily be good according to its fitness score. In order to guarantee population diversity, and avoiding a fast convergence caused by ANFIS, the diversity calculator considered is the FANO factor, which calculates the average variation of the mean and the membership functions according to 15. The population is reinitialized if the FANO factor is greater than a given threshold. Where? And in asterisk M is the number of membership functions in the inputs, GLI is the average of the ITH membership function of the LTH individual, and GEN is the current generation. The root mean squared error, RMSE, index used by ANFIS may not be appropriate for guiding the global search of an evolutionary algorithm while dealing with complex behaviors. Thus, a problem-oriented fitness function to evaluate candidate solutions must be designed. This function is significant because it provides the criteria to judge a solution and its performance. In addition, it is imperative to include several performance indicators to check solutions in a more precise and proper manner. This process is carried out by minimizing the following expression. The fitness function is composed of three indexes. Each one has been chosen to guide the evolution regarding features in the best solution. Thus, many possible solutions that do not have a near zero mean error but can forecast the series properly, will be explored. The Nash-Sutcliffe efficiency, NSE, is conceived as an overall performance measure. It is a normalized statistic that determines the relative magnitude of the residual variance compared to the measured data variance. A value of 1 corresponds to a perfect match of the model D to the observed data D. The mean absolute error, MAE, represents a clear interpretation of the absolute difference between the series and its forecasting, relative to the series. It is chosen instead of RMSE because the series has several peaks and it is necessary to rest importance on them in the forecasting. If it was not done, the fitness function would penalize errors in the lowest values, i.e., near the mean, more than in the highest ones. Prediction of change in direction, PSID, is a nonlinear index included to ensure that a forecast that does not fit the series well, but follows its direction changes reliably, gets a good score. As a multiplicative inverse, it causes an increase in the fitness function as large as how far the fitness score is from the optimal value. Where NSE equals 1 and MAE equals 0 represent the two roots of F, hence these are enough reasons to consider a solution as the best, but the PSID operates as a nonlinear penalizer.